The presence of $68 million of bank loans in the New York Central balance sheet at the end of 1932, or the bills payable of $69 million owned by Citi's service company on December 31, 1931. But certainly this adverse sign should not have been ignored. The more conservatively minded would have taken it as a strong